Hi everybody, and welcome back to Tech Interceptor. It hasn't been that long since the last video about one motherboard. To say the truth, not even one video ago, and today, considering that I don't knew what video to make, let's discover another new motherboard, maybe the chipset motherboard for AMD Ryzen 7000 release until now. Well, this is the new ASRock B650M HDV M2. But, as always, first of all, remember to subscribe to the channel, activate the notification bell to stay up to date on upcoming videos, and if you want, take a look at our Twitter and Instagram profiles. And let's get on now! The motherboard in question belongs of ASRock B650 lineup. Once opening the box, we find obviously the motherboard together the user manual, only one SATA 3 6GB 2nd cable, 2 M2 screw, and there is nothing else, so not a huge content. Dimensionally, the new ASRock B650 board has a micro ATX form factor and it size 24.4x22.6cm or 9.6x8.9 inches. In terms of aesthetic, monotone color scheme, the PCB is completely grey with many 45 degrees black lines, or is it the contrary? I don't know. Anyway, I'm certain that the all metal heatsink have a black finish. The cooling solution adopt is not exceptional, but it does its job. There is a very smallest element on top, while another more bigger on left. This has a white motif composed by a concentric rectangular printing on it. Moreover, we got a simple heatsink plate on the M2 socket and another yet more essential square on chipset. To reach the wall board, there are some words like a blazing M2 here as the motherboard name. As for design, that's it. There is nothing more to say, as you can see. But now we go to see its technical aspect. It has a VRM layout composed by 8+, 2+, 1 digital power faces that guarantee the maximum efficiency and the power necessary. At the core of a new board, there is the EM5 socket. This socket equipped two different boards, including the already mentioned B650 and the X670. The new AM5 socket supports the entire AMD Ryzen 7000 series desktop CPU that include 4 SKU, the Ryzen 9 7950X, Ryzen 9 7900X, Ryzen 5 7700X and Ryzen 5 7600X CPU. However, if you are some dubbed about the compatibility of your CPU, consult the manufacturer support for greater security. More precisely, in terms of specifications, there are dissimilar from each other. The Ryzen 5 7600X has a 6-core and 12-thread, 5.3 GHz of boost clock, 4.7 GHz of base clock, 38 MB of cache and 105 watts of TDP. The Ryzen 7 7700X has 8-core and 16-thread, 5.4 GHz of boost clock, 4.5 GHz of base clock, 40 MB of cache with a TDP of 105 watts. The Ryzen 9 7900X has a 12-core and 24-thread, 5.6 GHz of boost clock, 4.7 GHz of base clock, 76 MB of cache and 170 watts of TDP. Lastly, there is the Ryzen 9 7950X with a 16-core and 32-thread, 5.7 GHz of boost clock, 4.5 GHz of base clock, 80 MB of cache and 170 watts of TDP again. The same goes for the price, with the Ryzen 5 7600X sells at $300, the Ryzen 7 700X is around $400, the Ryzen 9 7900X at $550, and the Ryzen 9 7950X at $600. The motherboard is equipped with just 2 DDR5 DIMM dual-channel memory, the latest generation of memory technology for PC. Compared to a DDR4, despite a higher price, the DDR5 architecture is designed to provide some improvement, such as higher performance, high speed, as well as the unamplified capacity and a better power efficiency. We can install a minimum of 32GB for single DIMM memory module up to a maximum capacity of 64GB for all 2 DIMM. Operating frequency can range until to over 6400 MHz in overclocking. Moving to the layout internal connection, starting from the left on top, we have got a 8-pin ATX 12V power connector for our CPU, a CPU fan header and a header to use for chassis fan or for water pump fan. After going down on the right, there are a 24-pin ATX main power socket connector, a front panel Type-C USB 3.2 Gen 2 header, a SPI TPM header, and a USB 3.2 Gen 1 header. Oh, there is another USB 3.2 Gen 1 header and even 4 SATA 3 6GB/s port. In the bottom, this mobile feature a system panel header, a power LED and a speaker header, a clear CMOS jumper connector, a post status checker, a double USB 2.0 header, a chassis or water pump fan connector, after a 5-pin Thunderbolt AIC connector and a front panel audio header. Instead, back in the I/O panel, we got a display port, one HDMI port, a BIOS flashback button, 4 USB 2.0 Type E port, and a USB 3.2 Gen 1 Type C port, one 2.5 GB per second LAN port, 2 USB 3.2 Gen 1 Type E ports, and in the end, the audio jacks, including lining input port with a light blue finish, line out input and line coloring, and a microphone input port. For have more storage, the new B650 motherboard boasts 4 SATA 3 6GB/s connector and 2 M2 slot. One blazing M2 socket supports storage devices type 2280 PCI Express Gen 5 operating at a 4-4 mode, which means that these be able to running up to a 128GB/s. Instead, the second, the Hyper M2 socket, supports storage devices type 2260 and 2280 PCI Express Gen 4 operating at a 4-4 mode, so running up to 64GB/s. In terms of expansion slot, it has a 3 PCI Express, 1 reinforced PCI Express 5.0, 16x slots operating at a 4:16 mode, 1 another PCI Express 16x slot but 4.0, not reinforced and running at 4:4 mode, and 1 smaller PCI Express 4 1x slot. The audio compartment is very basic, this powered by a Realtek ELC897 audio codec that allow to have 7-point channel high definition audio and a dynamic audio feature. But now it is time to talk about the price. Well, the ASRock B650M HDV M2 motherboard is very, very cheap and you can find on sale at price of around $125 at the time of making this video. Don't worry, I leave you the all links to buy it in the description below. Alright, that's all for today. I hope you enjoyed this video and it was helpful. As always, let me know what do you think in the comments below, but leave a like, share it with all your friends and don't forget to subscribe. Huge thanks for watching, see you again next time.